Hey, welcome to Transmission number 8. It's been a while, so before telling you about some interesting marketplace news, I'm going to give you a roundup of recent project developments. So we've made some pretty good progress since our live YouTube Q&A in July, where I talked about strategy, partnerships, our ideas for developer outreach, and how we're going to start building the network. After a summer break in August, we've already made progress towards the project's main goal, building a peer-to-peer publish-subscribe messaging network for the world's real-time data. The dev team has not only begun the research and settled some of the big picture questions, they've put down a good chunk of working code already. So we are on track for the second release of the network at some point early next year. That second phase is where our peer-to-peer architecture is readied before phase 3, inviting the first outside organizations and projects to begin hosting network nodes. Doing that will mean us achieving decentralization for the first time. For the marketplace, the next significant feature release is community products. When it's up and running, we think it will be a world first. The feature will be key in allowing data to be crowdsourced from individual owners of devices, such as wearables, cars, and phones, bundling their data with others into one easy-to-buy product on our marketplace. The main technical difficulty is splitting up payments among a large group of data sellers, which easily hits the scalability limits of Ethereum 1.0. To solve this problem, we've implemented a Plasma sidechain variant modified for our use case. We've promised to write a comprehensive blog post about it, so stay tuned for when that drops. We've also been working on updating the editor. The whole app will look so much better than currently, and it will be a major step up in terms of user experience. We've also implemented some stability improvements for the backend, and you may have already noticed that canvases run much more reliably than before. Of course, it isn't just about what you build, it's also how you reach out. Our community has continued to grow as ever, and we recently hit 20,000 followers on Twitter. We've also really ramped up how we connect with outside developers. In mid-September, three members of Streamr, including Weilei Yu, our new head of developer outreach, went to one of Mexico's most prestigious technical universities to help run our first ever hackathon. There, the team interacted with hundreds of young students who competed to demonstrate how Streamr could be put to good use in the real world.
Una, dos, tres, Streamr!
But we're not stopping with that. In just a few weeks, we'll be hosting another hackathon at the Web3 Summit in Berlin, where we'll focus on smart city dApps. Straight after that, we'll be in Prague, sponsoring the Status Hackathon just before DevCon 4 kicks off. If you're around, come and join us. So finally, here's our news. Behind the scenes, Marketplace Operations has been working hard to find data buyers and sellers. Today, I can announce that a new and really promising Japanese artificial intelligence company, Daisy, has made Streamr's Marketplace their data provider of choice. That means they will be trying to source all their real-time data to feed and train their AI from our platform. If we can connect them with the right data vendors, marketplace activity should go up significantly. At the same time, we have a recent arrival to the marketplace, Cryptix, whose AI product monitors and predicts crypto prices. AI is a really fascinating frontier for data markets. In the last few years, we've heard about how much real-time data the AI sector will need to consume, and also how AI companies, just like Cryptix, will want to sell their analysis feeds. That demand is becoming a reality, and we're proud that Streamr is at the forefront of that. As ever, we'll have more news and updates soon. Thanks for joining. Bye.